Hello, I'm Brian. I'm here to teach you how to properly pack away a game of Wingspan, including the European expansion. So, we just wrapped up a game and I packed it away in probably 5 or 10 minutes. It does take a little bit, but it's worth it because everything fits in its spot really beautifully. Stonemaier Games, the designer of Wingspan and publisher of Wingspan, gives you a lot of materials to help stay organized. I found that a lot of people don't use that stuff though. It just ends up chaotic, makes it harder to play. But Wingspan is such a fun game that you want to be able to easily set up and pack away. So you can whip it out and be playing within like 10 minutes. Okay, so first of all, the obvious stuff, your boards have to fit in the top like this. So that's our major constraint as we're packing away this box. It's that sort of spatial dimension. And because there's five of them, they do take up a lot of thickness. So you have to have a good amount of space vertically in our box. Once we get inside though, things become a little bit more fluid and a little bit more flexible. I like to keep all of the bird cards stowed away in the big plastic box here. So all of them fit in there in stacks of three. Another helpful tip here, I like to keep my bird cards shuffled, and what I found is that you only go through about like half of one of these decks per game, and then you have all these cards that are still shuffled. So I like to keep my ones that I've used face up so I don't use them again, so I have a nice different game the next time I play. So then you just know what you've used recently. Anyway, so I keep them all in there. The bonus cards are in one of these little baggies somewhere in here. Yep. So I keep the bonus cards right in there in a baggie. And that way I don't have cards just kind of loose in this box. So that's really nice. You'll notice that I have kept some of the extra bags that Stonemaier gives you, just in case one of these rips, but I keep them tied up so that they're kind of tucked away to the side. Helps keep me organized. All right, another one of the constraints that you'll find is storing the bird feeder without fully disassembling it. It is definitely not designed to be fully disassembled every time. Once you assemble like all these cardboard pieces, they don't really like to be touched. You can even see some of mine are fraying, and that's just from lots of use, but that'll hold up as long as we don't try to disassemble it every time. So this has to fit opposite the box of our big plastic guy, because remember, our vertical distance is really important when we're packing away our game boards. So this has to be opposite of our card deck. And then I like to stick little bags of stuff in there. So the game pieces will fit really nicely in there. The end of round bonus goal cards, those fit really nicely in there. Even the dice will fit well in there, which is handy too, because that is kind of where they like to live, in the bird feeder. Okay, so that's all the easy stuff. And then these I really like to keep stacked. These are all of our foods. This is one of the largest bags that the game comes with, and if you stack them, and they nest nicely into each other, and as long as everything's packed away in here, you typically don't have issues with foods mixing later on, and then you're just like ready to go. Look, these are all set out, they're all separate, it's very easy to pick foods. So we've played like 50 games of Wingspan with this set, and everything stays organized, and it's quick to wrap up and to set up. So that's ideal for active gameplay. I hope you got something out of this video. You can just watch me sort of pack up so that we do it one more time. But yeah, happy playing. Great fun Wingspan game. If you wanna just keep filming me, babe, that'd be awesome. All right, so got this packed in here. extra bags. Taking up the most room on top. This fits rather nicely.